Hello, I am Nurul Athar, PMP, CPHIMS and ATAR Certified, and welcome to my presentation. In this presentation, I am going to talk about healthcare interoperability standards. Let's first explore what is interoperability. Interoperability is the ability of different information system, devices or applications to connect in a coordinated manner within and across organizational boundaries to access, exchange and cooperatively use data amongst stakeholders with goal of optimizing the health of individual and population. Now let's see what is standards. In healthcare, standards provide a common language and set of expectations that enable interoperability between different systems and our devices. Ideally, data exchange schema and standards should permit data to be shared between clinician, lab, hospital, pharmacy and patient regardless of application or vendor in order to seamlessly digest information about an individual and improve the overall coordination and delivery of healthcare. Example of healthcare interoperability standards: messaging standards, terminology standards, document standards, conceptual standards, architecture standards, and application standards. Okay. What is messaging standards? Messaging standards outline the structure, content and data requirements of electronic messages to enable the effective and accurate sharing of information. HL7 stands for Health Level 7 International Standard, promote interoperability of electronic health records. DICOM, Digital Imaging and Communication in Medicine for Radiology Images. NCPDP stand for National Council for Prescription Drugs Programs for the electronic exchange of healthcare information related to pharmacy services. IEEE stand for Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers, a standard for medical devices communications. And ASTM stand for American Society for Testing and Materials, a standard for content and structure of electronic health records. Now let's see terminology standards. Terminology standards provide a specific codes for terminologies and classifications for clinical concepts such as disease and medications. Terminology systems assign a unique code or value to a specific disease or entity. For example, Snomed-CT, the ICPC 2 code for asthma is R96. The terminology are used primarily to capture clinical information at point of care. As such, they are highly detailed, have predefined relationship and are fine-grained. Example, Snomed-CT for clinical terms, LOING for laboratory result. Now let's see classification systems such as ICD-10, AM, group related concepts together to satisfy. Now let's see classification. Classification system such as ICD-10 AM group related concept together to satisfy a specified use case, for example, causes of disease. Classification are more suited to recording and analysis of secondary use data such as research or epidemiology purpose. Now let's explore document standards. Document standard indicate the type of information included in a document and also the location of the information. Clinical document architecture, CTA, for electronic sharing of clinical documents and subjective objective assessment plan, so paper based. Now let's explore conceptual standards. Conceptual standards allow transmission of information between systems without any loss of the meaning or context of that information. HL7 reference information model DREAM provides a framework for describing health information and the context around it, i.e. who, what, when, where and how. Now let's explore architecture standard. Architecture standard define a generic model for health information system. For example, the SEN standard ENV12967 Health Information System Architecture or HISA provide an open architecture that is independent of technical specifications and applications. Now let's see application standard. Application standard determine implementation of business rule for software system to interact with each other. Okay, that brings us to end of my presentation. I hope you found this information useful.